just come to you tonight with no other desire than simply to meet with you. We thank you, Father, that you've made a way for us, that this is truly our portion.
Amazing grace. Through me. Chosen ones, you have come.
my sin grave to find my soul. Until I see you face to face, grace amazing takes me home. I trust in you. With all I am, I live to see your kingdom come. And in my heart, I pray you let your will be done. Until I see you face to face, and grace amazing takes me home, I trust in you.
Child in love. Child in all of you.
This is our cry. This is our prayer. This is our cry. Jesus, we glorify. Oh, in the sea. Into forgiveness, deliver us from temptation, your kingdom come, your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven, your kingdom.
Your kingdom. Thank you.
that once was crowned with thorns is crowned with glory now. The Savior knelt to wash our feet. Now at his feet.
Thank you. His heart for Israel. Yeah, take a moment and just begin to ask God to give you his heart for this nation. You know, we can't take it for granted that God gives his heart to people for the nation of Israel, his chosen people. So take a moment, ask the Lord for his heart. To give us what we ask. God, as we ask, as we seek you, God, you are faithful to answer our prayers. So tonight we'll be praying for the nation of Israel. As we pray for Israel, I encourage you to use your Bible as we pray. Your Bible is a sword, and with it you can tear down strongholds and release life. Father, I pray for your chosen people, these people whom you call your treasured possessions. Years ago, you delivered your chosen people out of Egypt and out of slavery. And 2,000 years ago, your son Jesus died on the cross so that all who believe in his name may be delivered out of the slavery to sin. I ask that you would cause the Jewish people to believe in the name of Jesus. I come against unbelief, and I break off hardness of heart. I break off generational strongholds of unbelief, doubt, agnosticism, and atheism. I release freedom over your people, freedom to believe in Jesus, and freedom from sin. Lord, I ask that non-religious Jews would have soft hearts and open ears to the gospel. I ask that the gospel we preach to your people and that seeds will be planted in their hearts. Lord, I ask that religious Jews who attend synagogue and are familiar with Jewish tradition and the Torah would cease striving for their salvation. Jesus, cause them to believe that your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Cause them to believe that you, as the Lamb of God, are the ultimate sacrifice for their sin. Jesus, you paid our debt, And I declare that your chosen ones are no longer slaves to sin, but they are free in Christ Jesus. Let's pray. Was spilled so that we may have relationship with you and with the Father. Jesus, you are the light of the world. Whoever follows you will not walk in darkness, but walk in the light. Lord, when you return, we will have a feast just like this one as we enter in to your eternal rest. Jesus, you are the Lord of the Sabbath, and all these things point to you. Holy Spirit, I ask that you would awaken your people to this truth that ultimately Jesus would be their source of rest. Lord, as your people read the word on the Shabbat, illuminate the scripture and reveal to them that the Messiah is Jesus. I tear down every lie, every accusation that says that Jesus is not the Savior. Holy Spirit, stir up renewed hope and hunger in the hearts of Jewish people to know you, Jesus, and to have a relationship with you. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Lord, I release a fresh grace over your people in Israel to receive this free gift and experience the power of the resurrection in their lives. I ask that the Messianic Church in Israel would rise up at this hour and preach the gospel with boldness and with the power of the Holy Spirit. I ask that you would give church leaders wisdom and insight to know how to preach the gospel lovingly, effectively, and powerfully. I ask that the Messianic Church would step up in faith and share the gospel with their co-workers, family members, neighbors, and friends. And I ask, Father, that you would strengthen the church as they face persecution. I ask that their response to persecution would be joy and praise. I declare that those who suffer for the sake of the gospel are blessed. I declare that, God, you honor those who suffer for your name's sake. You have not forgotten them, and their reward is great in heaven. Let's pray.
Thank you.
demonic agendas directed toward Israel. I declare that the plans of the enemy to harm, kill, or destroy your chosen people will not prevail. Jesus, you were given the name of King of Kings because you are victorious. The weapons of the enemy shall not prosper. God, you will prevail, and your promises will prevail. Father, you are their fortress. You are their protector. I declare that, Father, you have a good inheritance in store for your people, and they will receive the fullness of that inheritance. You have not forgotten your covenant with your people. God, you have not forgotten your covenant with your people. God, you have not forgotten your covenant with your people. Jesus, you are faithful and you are true. And I declare that there will be a revival in Israel in the last days. Israel, arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. And the world may fall into deep darkness, but the nations will come to the brightness of Israel's rising. Let's pray. for Israel. You are not against Israel. We thank you that, God, you are faithful, you are true, and you will fulfill your promises to Israel in your timing. God, you are good. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
By your Spirit, we know that the day is coming and is coming soon. Your name will be lifted high by every tribe and tongue. Every nation will declare you as Lord. We thank you, Father, that even right now you are gathering your redeemed. You're calling forth your sons and daughters at this hour from every nation. We thank you, God, for the work that you are doing in Israel. The same way that you opened up our eyes when we were still blind, when we were still deaf, when we were still dead in our transgressions. You are a God who came to us and saved us. Father, we know that you're able to do the same for your people in Israel. We prophesy what you've done for the Gentiles, what you've done for us. We prophesy this over your people in Israel. They will arise. They will come forth into the newness, into your marvelous light. We pray, Father, that you would raise up your prophets at this hour, that you would awaken your messengers, your preachers, those who you have called to bear the stigma of your message, those who will do it with boldness, those who will do it unto you. We thank you, Father, that this is what you're doing at this hour. We come into partnership with what you're doing out in the nations through our worship and through our prayer. We thank you, God. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you for joining us tonight. We hope that you are blessed. This month for Thursday evenings, we will be continuing to pray on behalf of Israel. And for those who find this to be something new, praying for Israel, we promise that it gets easier. The more God gives you a heart for his people, the easier it gets to lift up what God's doing in his people of Israel. So we hope that you enjoy tonight, and we hope to see you again next week. We have a Wednesday morning watch at 9:30 in the morning. Otherwise, we'll see you on Thursday evening at 8 p.m. once again. Have a wonderful night.